A molten salt reactor uses liquid fuel rather than solid fuel.
With liquid fuel, the size and shape of the container is crucial. Pumping the fuel into a cylindrical vessel places uranium atoms close enough to each other to sustain a nuclear chain reaction. If something goes wrong and it starts to overheat, the liquid expands and the uranium atoms become too dispersed to maintain fission. So it starts cooling down passively. And in the case of a total loss of station power, like Fukushima, the design employs another safety feature. Below the reactor chamber is an emergency reservoir. The drain leading to the reservoir is plugged by the same salt mixture, but it is refrigerated so that it freezes solid. Without electricity to keep it cool, the plug quickly melts, and the liquid fuel drains into the emergency reservoir. Unlike the reactor chamber, the shape and size of the emergency reservoir ensures the uranium atoms are too far apart to sustain a chain reaction. It cools down and eventually freezes. Crisis averted. At Oak Ridge, they successfully ran and tested a molten salt reactor for 4 years. The design works.
Even in the worst type of accident scenario, even if you don't have any external electric power, like what happened at Fukushima, even if you don't have any operators on site, they're able to shut themselves down.
The basic science is well understood, but building a reactor that can withstand something as corrosive as a very hot bath of salt is a huge engineering challenge. It is the focus of early testing for Leslie's startup company, Transatomic.
We can make something that works for 5 years, that works for 10 years. Like that, we certainly know. What we're trying to figure out now is whether we can use newer materials or new methods of corrosion control to extend the lifetime of the facility. Because ultimately, we care about making this low cost. If you have to replace your key components every 10 years, it's not going to be cheaper than coal, and if it's not cheaper than coal, then it's not worth doing.
But coal and all fossil fuels carry another cost to the environment. In Japan, with the nukes mothballed, they have kept the lights burning by burning imported fossil fuels, mostly liquid natural gas. The result? A steady increase in greenhouse gas emissions, reversing the nation's ambitious reduction plan signed just 2 years before the Fukushima disaster.
If you're concerned about climate change, you need to be open to nuclear power. I think that there's no way that the world will meet its carbon reduction goals without including nuclear in the mix.
All over the world, the demand for energy grows exponentially in emerging economies. China opens a new coal-fired power plant about once a week. Can the world respond to the relentless demand for energy without worsening climate change? Is it time to rethink the nuclear option?
The fate of the whole planet depends on us renewing our energy system with renewables and with nuclear. And if we step back from that, we are going to create a tremendous problem for future generations.